First, though, our guest this morning on the program is the Leader of the Opposition and a Leader of the Opposition in the Senate and the Shadow Workplace Relations Minister, Senator Eric Abett. Senator, good morning to you.
Good morning. Good to be on the program.
Thank you. The Holden has announced more than 100 jobs to go from its manufacturing plant in Elizabeth in Adelaide's northern suburbs. This is going to be done through attrition. Permanent workers will be kept. This would have been worse, wouldn't it, under the Coalition, if you scrap the multi-million dollars in subsidies that the government is going to offer the car manufacturers?
Absolutely not. The Coalition is concerned to ensure that we talk about the quality of the spend, not the quantity of the spend in relation to the car industry. And if you get the quality of the spend right, you can in fact decrease the quantity of the spend.
Even by $500 million?
Yes, and indeed the Labor Party at one stage has reduced its commitment by $1 billion to the Australian automotive manufacturing sector. So let's keep that in mind, that Labor makes huge promises and then never is able to follow through. The Coalition has a proud record in relation to the car industry and economic management. You can do both. Labor can do neither, and that's the difficulty.
Is there part of this which is inevitable, given that the dollar is so high at the moment?
Clearly, the high Australian dollar is putting pressure, especially on those manufacturers that are seeking to export vehicles made in Australia. That stands to reason. But today we have had the president of Toyota indicating that one of the problems Australian car manufacturers are facing is, in fact, the workplace relations regime. And you will recall that a few years ago, Mitsubishi Australia closed down its plant, saying, we've had enough of all the money, no amount of government money will keep us here, and they closed down.
Is workplace relations something that, workplace relations policy something that the Shadow Cabinet's going to sign off on today?
We won't be signing off on a final policy, because we have said publicly a number of times that the Fair Work Act inquiry that Labor has initiated, that will be finalised by about May or middle of this year, is something that we as a coalition will be watching very carefully to learn from it and help inform our policy position. But when somebody like Toyota comes out in the public arena, having been the beneficiary of a lot of government largesse, nevertheless making the point about workplace relations being so important and the need for flexibility, and the government simply not willing to address that issue, it shows that they have become the prisoner of the union bosses rather than the concern for keeping workers' jobs in Australia.
The head of Toyota, Max Yasuda, the comments you referred to, he also was critical of Australia's workplace culture, critical of what he says is the culture of absenteeism. Do you have sympathy for him on that?
Clearly, that is the experience in Toyota, that there is a culture of absenteeism, and that is ultimately costing jobs. And that is where I believe the trade union leadership of this country have a great leadership role to play if they actually wanted to, and that is to condemn absenteeism and not condone it and actually actively campaign against it, because these people that engage in absenteeism are increasing the cost of manufacturing and therefore increasing the likelihood of, in this case Toyota, closing down, scaling down, or having other parts of its manufacturing process done overseas. So absenteeism ultimately costs jobs, and that is something that every single Australian worker needs to understand, and more importantly, every trade union shop steward and boss needs to tell their members that absenteeism is a thing of the past, it costs jobs, and it's got to stop.
Well, let's look at the equal pay ruling yesterday for community services workers. Business groups are warning of risks to the workplace relations system. The danger, Heather Ridout for one, says it could lead to a raft of union claims in other industries. We're already seeing suggestions from the aged care nurses that they are going to refer to this ruling in their own bid for wage increases. Do you think that it could spark a whole raft of increases or at least claims like we're hearing from the business groups?
There was a very strong dissenting judgment in the Fair Work Australia ruling from Commissioner Watson.
Only one yeah, of the five commissioners.
Yes, that's right. And he made those points in his dissenting ruling. So
do you agree with him?
Do we believe in equal pay for equal work? Yes, we do. And now that that decision has been made by the umpire, it is beholden upon the government to ensure the money is there for these charitable organisations to be able to continue without the need for cutting services. But there will no doubt be a flow-on effect because people will be talking about pay parity.
Is that a good thing?
Unfortunately, it will be inflationary unless there are productivity offsets. And that is one of the great difficulties with this ruling, that whilst we accept the decision of the umpire, I think it will have flow-on consequences. And those that have spoken about that, including the dissenting judgment, I think make a very important point that this should be seen is a one-off case and not the start of a whole lot of other cases which will simply drive wage inflation.
So you accept it, but you don't necessarily agree with the judgment?
We accept the judgment, and in Australia, Fair Work Australia is the umpire. That decision has been made. We accept it. We realise that there are consequences from it, and that is what we've got to ensure is managed and managed properly. And I'm not sure that Federal Labor fully understand the flow-on consequences.
Okay. Let's look now at that email or the set of emails that your office obtained through Freedom of Information through Fair Work Australia relating to the investigation into the Craig Thompson matter and the Health Services Union. These are old, aren't they? They were released publicly by the government last year in the Parliament, in the Senate Committee.
Mr. Shorten has tried to make that claim. That is false. Mr. Shorten claimed that these were released in the Parliament on December the 9th. The Parliament wasn't sitting on December the 9th.
But the Hansard suggests that Workplace Relations Minister did release the detail that an advisor had been in contact.
What we had was a question on notice being answered, suggesting that there had been email contact. But of course, what we weren't told was the content of the email contact, and it is the content of these emails which is so explosive, and that is why when we put in a Freedom of Information request seeking the emails, Fair Work Australia denied us access, and we had to appeal to the Information Commissioner to get Fair Work Australia to make them available. So if Mr. Shorten believes that these are such benign emails, such old news, why on earth did Fair Work Australia try to block access to me to those emails?
Are they really explosive, though? It looks like they're dealing only with the media management of the issue, not that the government's trying to influence the investigation.
And that is the very sad fact, and you've made the point exactly, that the Minister's office was only concerned about the media management, not about the ongoing delays of a 3-year investigation that was dragging on longer than Blue Hills. People were wondering what on earth is going on, and what was the Minister's focus? The political imperative, the media management, not the management of his portfolio.
But it does show they weren't trying to influence the investigation.
We don't know that. That which has been released would suggest that there was a degree of familiarity between Senator Evans' office at the time and Fair Work Australia, which doesn't look good for either side. But the fact that they were so concentrated on media management rather than administrative management gives you a good insight into this Labor government. They're concerned about the spin, never about the substance.
Senator Abetz, appreciate your time. Thanks for that.
Thanks a lot.